In today's video, let's take a look at an Excel chart trick. Let's create a bar chart that automatically shows negative values in a different color to positive values. What I'm also going to do is to show you how you can conditionally format the bar chart to highlight the bar with the highest value. Now, the trick that you see here is something that you can apply to any chart that you want to conditionally format. Let's check it out. I have a list of products and the sales value for actual and budget. What I'd like to do is create a bar chart for the actual sales, but I'd also like to show the deviation to budget. So it's going to be two bar charts that are grouped as one visualization. So let's start off with the simple part first. So select a product, select actual, go to insert, go to the bar chart area here, and select 2D bar. Now let's quickly update the formatting of this. I'm going to remove the vertical grid lines here. Let's also remove the label axis. Let's right mouse click and add the labels directly to the bars. Let's also update the product names by making them stand out a bit more. So I'm going to go with bold and make them bigger. Another thing that I usually prefer to do in bar charts is to reduce the gap width between the bars. So select a series and press Ctrl 1 to bring up the series options, or you can also double click on the bars to bring this up. For gap width, let's go with 80%. With the series selected, let's also quickly adjust the shape fill. Okay, so far so good. I'll just make this a bit thinner. Now, just be careful about your labels here. So there are two things you can control. This is the chart area, and this here is the plot area. So just make sure that there is enough breathing space for the labels. I'll make this even thinner. Now, you might have noticed the order of the products is different to the order of the products in the table. It's the other way around. If you'd like them to be in the same order, you can directly adjust this in the chart. So click on the axis, go to series options, under axis options, place a check mark for categories in reverse order. Now we have the same order as our table. Another thing I'm going to add to this is the horizontal grid lines. Because I'm planning to add a second bar chart on the side that shows the deviation, it's going to make it easier to read if I have horizontal grid lines in there. So let's go and place a check mark for the grid lines, but by default, it puts the vertical ones. I want the major horizontal ones. So let's place a check mark here, and let's also make it even lighter. So far so good. I'm going to remove the border of the chart. So let's go to format, shape outline, no outline. Okay, so the first chart is done. Now let's add the deviation to budget. For that, I first need to calculate my values. So I'm going to add a data preparation area on the side here. This is going to be the difference. And the formula is simple. It's just actual minus budget. Okay, so let's just pull this down. I want to plot this in a separate bar chart. So let's highlight our products first, hold down Control, highlight the difference column, go to insert, and go back and select the bar chart. Now I'd like to have this formatted in a similar way to my original bar chart. Now here's a trick. Click on the original bar chart and press Control C. Now select the new chart, go to Home, under Paste, go to Paste Special, and select Formats. This is going to copy the formats from the first chart and bring it over to the second chart. One thing I don't want to have on the second chart, though, are the labels. So I'm going to click on the labels here. If I press Delete, it's going to delete the labels, but it's also going to delete my axes. So I want to keep the axes, but just hide the labels. With the axis selected, go to Series Options, under Labels, for Label Position, instead of Next to Axis, select None. That keeps your line, but hides the labels. Now, this is going to be in front of this one here. Let's just move these. To be able to properly see the chart that's behind this, let's take away the white fill color of this new chart. Let's go to Format, Shape Fill, and select No Fill. Okay, so now they are right beside each other. Now, the one thing you need to be careful is that these series don't overlap. So the plot area of this one and the plot area of this one don't overlap. So I'm just going to move this slightly to the side as well. Okay, so far so good. Now let's get to our conditional formatting. I want to have a different color for negative values. Select a series, go to Fill Options. Here's the setting you need, invert if negative. Take a look at the color here. I just currently have the choice to select one color, but the moment I place a check mark for invert if negative, I get a second color. This color here, the first one, is the color I want to have for positive values. So I'm just going to go with a light green. And the second color is what I want to have for negative values. I'll just go with orange. It's that easy to conditionally format this chart. Let's just make sure that it's dynamic. So for product B, I currently have a minus 10 as my difference. Let's change that to 1 to 65, and I have plus 5. Let's press Ctrl Z to go back. Now, as a bonus tip, I want to show you how you can conditionally format any series in a chart based on any type of logic. As long as you can write a formula for that logic, you can do conditional formatting in the chart. So let's say for actuals, I want to highlight dynamically the product that had the highest sales, right? So I don't want to fix it. I don't want to go and select specifically this one and color it because that's going to fix that color to this position right here. I want it to be dynamic. The trick is to add a new series for whatever you want to conditionally format. So I'm going to call this Max Condition. This series is only going to have one number. That number is the max value. And this max value has to be in the correct position. Let me show you what I mean. The formula I need here is to say if this value here, if this happens to be the max of my range, so I'm going to highlight this and press F4 to fix it because I'm planning to pull this down. So if it happens to be the max, then I want to see this value. Otherwise, I want to see nothing or zero. So close the bracket, press Enter, and let's pull this down. So right now, I should just see one value. Whenever it comes across the max, it's going to show it on this side. The next step is to bring this inside the chart. So let's go to the chart, right mouse click, select data. Let's add a new series. The series name is my max condition, and the series values are all these, right? So you have to be consistent. The starting point is from product A to product E, and click on OK and OK. So now I have my second series in there. And by default, what Excel does is it plots it right beside it. But there is a setting that we can tweak so it actually plots it over the original series. And that's called series overlap. So instead of 0%, we want to increase this to 100%. Now all we have to do for this entire series, we can adjust the color. Let's go with a blue color. Now, the advantage of doing this way is that it's dynamic. So let's say now we have product B going up to 1360. This gets updated automatically, and so does our difference on this side. Okay, so this is the trick for doing any type of conditional formatting in a chart. If you're dealing with negative values, though, you don't need to bother and add another series. You can use invert if negative. Now there is one thing we can do here because our title disappeared. I'm just going to bring this to the side. And actually, let's just connect this to this. And let's also group these two charts together so we can move them as one. So hold down Control, select both, right mouse click, group, and group these together. So now I can move them around as one visualization.
I hope you enjoyed this Excel chart trick. Hit that thumbs up if you did, and subscribe before you leave in case you aren't subscribed yet. And I'm going to see you in the next video.